Good morning. I'm very delighted to present this keynote at IEEE Sustainable Power and Energy Conference 2020 in the panel Integration Demand Side Flexibility Resources into Power System Operation. I'm very grateful to the organizers for the invitation and in particular to Professor Ding. Today I'm going to present the keynote titled The Scalable Privacy Preserving Distributed Parallel Optimization of Residential Photovoltaic Battery Systems for Flexibility Provision in Electricity Markets. In this presentation, after briefly introducing the procurement of flexibility resources in the ancillary services market, I will talk about an architecture for the large-scale aggregation of consumers that we have designed and developed at the University of Salerno in the context of an Italian pilot project. The architecture has been designed to allow an aggregator to participate in the ancillary service market for providing flexibility, solving day-ahead and real-time optimizations. Then I will describe an innovative distributed parallel linear programming based optimization that is scalable and privacy preserving, allowing to deal with hundreds of thousands of prosumers without disclosing their information. I will then present some results based on the real Italian pilot project, and finally I will present some findings and conclusions. As known, future electricity distribution grids will host a considerable share of the distributed renewable energy sources, and the electric power is undergoing a rapid transition toward decarbonization and decentralization. In particular, residential and commercial customers, once simply consumers of electricity, are deploying distributed energy resources, becoming producers themselves in a new, increasingly decentralized power system. The flexibility offered by these new resources and technologies can reduce the electricity and infrastructure cost while enabling the power sector to meet the decarbonization targets. Modern power systems are evolving from a centralized paradigm according to which electrical energy was mainly generated by large power plants at the transmission level to a new decentralized, layered decomposition optimization model where distributed generation, often based on renewable energy sources, represents a relevant portion of the produced electrical energy. In this new model, the provision of ancillary services to the transmission system operator should take into account the possible flexibility furnished by new distributed resources, such as dispersed and small generators, also based on renewable energy sources, and preferentially endowed with small batteries. In particular, distributed battery energy storage systems, also of small scale, that were mainly used to decrease the uncertainty due to renewable energy sources and to increase the energy self-consumption for the end user, can be also managed to provide energy flexibility to the transmission system operator. Battery energy storage systems can be directly managed by the transmission system operator or controlled by an aggregator that can offer energy flexibility in the ancillary services market. Considering this new model of modern power systems, and in order to exploit the potential of energy flexibility offered by new resources, the European regulatory framework has opened the ancillary services market to distributed energy resources, including energy storages and demand response providers. Among distributed energy resources, battery energy storage systems have gained recently more attention from many scholars, evaluating their involvement in the ancillary service market due to their higher ramp rate and fast response. The proposed methods consider both the planning and the real-time sessions to respectively define the unit commitment and the activation of flexibility resources According to the Italian Ancillary Services Market, considering a pay as bid mechanism and a settlement period of 50 minutes, an aggregator, after carrying out a day-ahead optimization based on the day-ahead forecast, can offer services of flexibility in the up and or down mode during the planning session, considering its baseline as a reference. If the offers are accepted by the transmission system operator, it can ask the aggregator to deliver the flexibility provision during the real-time session. If the energy is not delivered, an imbalance cost is applied accordingly. The aggregator should carry out a real-time optimization based on short-term forecast to not pay the imbalance cost. It is worth noting that in the last years, the Italian regulatory authority implemented a new regulation that allowed aggregated distributed energy resources to participate in the market for ancillary services. According to this new regulation, an aggregate can be composed of different types of resources, including generators, loads, battery energy storage systems, electric vehicles, and so on, without any limit to the rated power of the single resource, but the aggregate must have an overall minimum regulating power. To implement the distributed parallel optimization and allow the exchange of energy data among all the prosumers, distributed intelligent devices based on information and communication technology should be used. It is so assumed that all prosumers are endowed with a home device gateway, a smart meter, allowing near real-time communication of the energy data flow, and an energy management system, which is a hardware device such as a Raspberry platform. A management system platform based on an information communication technology infrastructure and software applications is also required for evaluating the absorbed and ejected power for all prosumers, exchanging information between the prosumers and managing all the batteries. The considered large-scale aggregation of prosumers can be managed by using the implemented layered architecture, where each energy management system can perform a local optimization. The layered architecture consists of a physical layer and a virtual layer that is essentially a virtual platform where all prosumers can access. The physical layer provides grid connection, smart metering, and communication to all prosumers. The virtual layer includes an energy information system, allowing a local site awareness based on real-time monitoring and on tools for the forecasting of photovoltaic production and load demand. By accessing to the virtual layer, the prosumers can exchange only some privacy-preserving information related to their local optimal solutions and their power flexibility contributions to fulfill the global constraints of the global optimization problem, as it will be explained in the following. The virtual layer is based on the distributed ledger technology and on smart contracts to achieve both the day-ahead and real-time distributed parallel optimizations while preserving the privacy of all prosumers. The considered approach is based on a pilot project that we are carrying out in Italy for the procurement of flexibility resources in the Italian ancillary services market. In the day-ahead problem, the aggregator aims at maximizing the remuneration due to the provision of the energy flexibility in the ancillary services market and minimizing the operating costs of the prosumers. For the up-down regulation, the global constraints related to the minimum power that the aggregate should provide are shown in these equations, where the provided flexibility is related to the baseline of the aggregation, calculated as the sum of the power profiles of the prosumers, considering that the batteries use a native control strategy for improving self-consumption. Some local constraints should be considering. This includes the power balance of each prosumer, power limits from 2 degrees for each prosumers, power charging these changing speeds of the batteries. If the offer is then accepted by the transmission system operator, the aggregator should guarantee the provision of an amount of energy flexibility in the time ranges defined by the discrete variables. The real-time optimization problem is thus obtained by the day-ahead one by fixing the discrete variables as decided during the day-ahead optimization by the aggregator. If the optimization problem is subject to the quality constraints determined by the energy flexibility that has been accepted by the transmission system operator as shown here. The same local constraints of the day-ahead optimization are considered. The real-time optimization can be carried out every 15 minutes to update the control signals for the batteries, to adapt to the changes of the photovoltaic productions and electrical loads of each prosumer, considering that the proposed parallel optimization is very fast. The discrete variables can be identified during the day-ahead in a centralized way by using a mixed integral linear programming optimization model, or in a heuristic way by using a new two-stage method based on hybrid variable neighborhood search and distributed parallel optimization. The centralized formulation is enabled to deal with extra large instances arising from real-world scenarios. So, by solving the problem in a heuristic way, can achieve a distributed parallel framework in which all prosumers participate in solving the problem in a faster way, also keeping the information not disclosed. The way we accomplish this mission is by breaking down the centralized problem into many linear programming formulations and solving the resulting linear programming problems in a distributed parallelized way. A new distributed optimization method based on linear programming is designed that overcomes the previous methods based on integral and quadratic programming, such as alternating directional method of multipliers. The proposed method is scalable, allowing to deal with hundreds of thousands of prosumers in real time. It is privacy preserving. A global solution can be found without any prosumer knowing the behavior or objectives of any other one. It can be implemented by using the described architecture, where each prosumer performs an optimization based on its specific objective function. As regards with the distributed parallel linear programming based optimization, the idea behind it is that distributing the right-hand side of the global constraint among all prosumers. Each prosumer solves the following optimization problem in such a way so that the minimum power flexibility contribution of each prosumer is determined by the energy reserve available in its battery according to this equation shown here. The update of the term gamma in the objective function is achieved in the virtual layer by a smart contract. The basic intuition behind the above formula is that we increase the weights by a larger amount on those constraints which are more violated. Now I will first present some results obtained considering the centralized optimization. More details can be found in this paper. The study, the large-scale aggregate, consists of 2,000 residential users, all of them endowed with a controllable photovoltaic battery system, a proprietary sized by each user according to its contractual power and energy consumption. In this figure, we can observe the state of charge performance for a day in April in the case of upregulation for the bull aggregate. In the lower part of the figure, we can see the average power in a quarter of an hour related to the photovoltaic production of the bull aggregate, the absorbed power for the baseline, and the absorbed power for up regulation. The up regulation session is delivered for 4 consecutive hours from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. When we look at the results overall the year, and in particular to the mean of the daily objective function of the aggregate and to the mean of the daily remuneration of the aggregate, we can see that from March to September, the participation of the aggregate both in the up and down and in the up regulation allows obtaining a daily remuneration that is higher than the daily cost related to the purchase of electricity from the network, making the objective function positive. If we look at the results in this figure, where we can see the mean of the daily increment of the energy cost for users of the aggregate in the case of up and down regulation during 1 year, it is clear that in the case of up regulation, in the months from March to October, the cost due to the energy absorbed by the electricity grid are the same as in the case without regulation. In the case of up and down regulation, on the other hand, there is a modest increase in the cost for the aggregate in the months from March to October. It is also important to point out that the impact on the self-consumption from photovoltaic generation and on the lifetime of the batteries is negligible. Now I will present some results obtained with the innovative scalable privacy-preserving distributed parallel optimization method. More details can be found in this paper. An aggregation of 2,000 prosumers is considered that can satisfy the flexibility constraints of 1 MW, according to the Italian regulation. The average power in a quarter of an hour of the absorbed power for the baseline and in the case of up regulation in June are shown for the centralized optimization and for the parallelized distributed linear programming based optimization. The up regulation is delivered for 4 consecutive hours. In this case also from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. If compared with the centralized optimization, the proposed day-ahead parallelized distributed optimization can achieve the same flexibility in terms of delivered energy in the mentioned period, and both have the same value of the objective function. Considering a day-ahead forecast error of 20% for the electrical load and of 10% for the photovoltaic production, the absorbed powers related to the day-ahead real-time optimization are shown in this figure for the period from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. It is worth noting that regardless of the forecast error, the parallel real-time optimization can achieve a power profile very close to that accepted during the day-ahead in the ancillary services market, thus not incurring in any penalty. As shown in this other figure, when considering the computational time of the variable neighboring search parallelized linear programming-based optimization by varying the number of prosumers, considering the month of June, for example, it is clear that the proposed day-ahead method is highly scalable, allowing to deal with hundreds of thousands of prosumers. It is worth noting that when considering the real-time parallel optimization, the computational time varies between 13 and 25 milliseconds when considering different days during the year. Now, let's move on to the final comments. To end, I'd like to highlight that linear programming-based parallelization enables not only to perform in an almost real-time way for very large scale world, but also to fulfill the privacy of prosumers. Both day-ahead and real-time optimizations, being highly scalable and able to protect the personal information of prosumers, overcome typical drawbacks of centralized methods. The proposed linear programming-based optimization methods can be easily coded up and implemented on microcontrollers and connected to the implemented layered architecture. Here there is a list for further selected readings on this topic. Thank you so much for your interest and attention. I would now be interested to hear from you with your thoughts or questions. If anyone like more information or has questions, please feel free to contact me by email.